Hey, Jody here. This is my friend Andrew Cardin. This video is on 12-inch pipe, all downhill, 532 6010 root,
3/16 filling cap.
In an earlier video, we strictly showed the root pass on this pipe, and this is Andrew here going to the bottom half of it. Got a few good arc shots along with some tips on body positioning and things like that, so you can make sure that you get a good line of sight. That's super important, and the body positioning comes in because you're moving pretty fast once you get the root pass in with those large rods. So you got to move your body and maintain a good line of sight at the same time. So that was the root pass. I will link up the root pass video link right here. So this is just a little review on body positioning. Starts with grabbing that stinger, that whip, which is a light gauge super flex cable whip, grabbing it so that it won't hang on anything with the other hand, and then making a few dry runs and knowing what you're gonna do before you do it on body positioning. He's getting a little more slack there because he could feel it kind of binding a little bit. And then for the second half, the bottom half, a different body positioning, going underneath, making sure that he can move his body, propping with his left hand, holding the right hand stinger, and moving his head so he maintains a line of sight to see the puddle. Those are all very fundamental things. Okay, we're going up now on amperage for the hot pass, going up on size of the rod as well. Use the 532 for the root. Now we're going to 3/16 diameter, 7010. 155 amps is what we're gonna start with. 3/16 hippie rods, HYP for high yield pipe. Ground the root pass. That is part of the procedure where Andrew works. It's not necessarily the procedure everywhere, and it's not necessarily needed for every pipe joint. But pretty much the objectives for a hot pass are don't leave any voids or slag behind, so you got to burn into the root, and don't blow through or reshape or remelt the root on the other side. So it's a balancing act a little bit, especially with the 3/16 rod. So Andrew's stepping out here a little bit, keeping the puddle cooled off as he moves down. You're going to notice a difference in techniques as we get to different parts of the pipe. From 12 o'clock on down to probably, I don't know, 2 o'clock or so, it's going to be relatively the same, but it's going to gradually change as he gets further down the pipe until the overhead portion, the last third of the pipe or so, you're going to notice a distinct difference in the technique, in the whip and pause type motion. You can see Andrew starting to whip out of the puddle just a little bit more and a little bit more, and right here he's coming way out of the puddle. This is getting around the bottom. This is to make the deposit pretty much even all the way around, so you don't have a heavy bottom and a light top. He's got that requirement of a 1/16 max on the cover pass. So that's the hot pass. We'll wire wheel that all the way off, and then that's it, wire wheeled. And now for the next pass, the fill pass after the hot pass. Again, 3/16 diameter, 7010 rods. So the technique here is going to be pretty much the same, except there's no real concern about melting through the root now that he's got that nice, thick, heavy hot pass on there. So keeping that rod moving at a pretty good rate, trying to keep a favorable rod angle, a drag angle coming off the top, and then more of a straight angle, but a little bit of a drag anyway, coming down vertical, and then the angle change a little bit down on the bottom, as well as, again, that amount of whip and pause, the amount that he comes in and out of the puddle will change as he gets down on the bottom third or so. Every time I post a video with Andrew using his pancake hood, I get questions about what's up with this weird funky hood, this custom made hood, this homemade hood, whatever. It's not a homemade hood. It's an off the shelf thing, and it's very common amongst pipeliners and folks that weld outdoors because it seals all that glare, all that sunlight out of the helmet. You can just see the puddle that much better. Andrew's using a arc single auto dark 2x4 lens in there though, which I since bought one. We got an 11 for him for this particular video. I got a 10 and put it in my small cardboard Huntsman helmet. I really like it. You can see the technique change now. Really utilizing the fast freeze characteristic of the rod coming out of the puddle further. Rod angle is almost straight in toward the center of the pipe. And the whip and pause is very distinct, coming out of the puddle, letting that ripple solidify a lot before getting back in there. Wire wheel time, let's look at that in slow motion. You see that? You see each one of those ripples just almost completely solidifying before Andrew gets back in there. That's just to control the height, to control the deposit on the bottom to keep from having too heavy of a cap. I'm sure somebody's figured out some other techniques that work, but this is the one Andrew's using today. We're going up to 165 amps now. This is the last fill pass before the cover pass. And if you haven't figured it out yet, we're just doing one side of this pipe because, you know, both sides are the same. And it makes for a more reasonably short video just to do all the passes but on one side. So he is stirring that puddle around in almost like a bunch of little circles for this one, letting it wash into those sidewalls. That's so, you know, the puddle gets wider as you come out, so you've got to do a little bit of a different technique rather than just a straight on whip and pause sometimes. Looks like he's digging pretty good. Rod angle is a little bit of a drag angle coming off 12 o'clock. And then after he gets past, you know, the 3 o'clock portion, rod angle begins to change a little bit less of a drag. But right now it's still a little bit of a drag here. Notice again that Andrew's holding on to that light gauge whip just to keep it from messing with him, keep it from hanging on anything on the floor, the leg of the tripod vise, or whatever. Just kind of holding that thing with just enough slack that it's not affecting his steadiness. All right, a little more of the same, and we'll see a little bit of a change in technique again once we get down to the bottom portion. Now we're starting to see a little bit more whip and pause, and right about here we see a little bit of change in technique, more whip and pause coming out of the puddle again, much like the last pass, allowing it to solidify a little bit and gradually doing it a little bit more and more as he gets closer toward 6 o'clock. After a quick wire wheel, ready for the cover pass, is in pretty good shape, just a little bit sunken in. So putting a 1/16 height on cap should be no problem. Going down to 145 amps for the cover pass. If you stick the rod, this is the way to avoid arc strikes. Just unclamp the stinger and then pull the rod loose. And you don't want arc strikes anywhere outside of the bevel, anywhere outside that they're not gonna be covered up with weld. It's a good habit to get into. Instead of trying to pull the electrode loose, just undo the stinger, then pull the electrode loose. You save yourself a whole lot of arc strikes. You're going to see much the same thing here. Andrew just working the puddle back and forth a little bit here, trying to tie in, watching his height, doing whatever he feels like it takes. And one more rod will pretty much wrap it up. And that is the good thing about 3/16 rod. You can make it a long, long run. So you can usually go on a 12-inch pipe like this, you know, from 3 o'clock here all the way down to 6. All right, technique hasn't changed a whole lot yet. Just like the other passes, you're going to see it change as he gets closer to the bottom. Just trying to just tie into those edges of the bevel. Again, watching the speed of travel and the height of the deposit, trying to stay below that 1/16 maximum height of the cap that's in the API 1104 code. His inspectors are pretty strict about that. All right, now you can see the change in technique a little bit. He gets pretty close to the 6 o'clock. Now he's whipping in and out a little bit and doing just a little bit of side to side sometimes to make sure it washes in and ties into the edges of the bevel. Again, this is just to control that bead height. It's hard to maintain that same exact technique all the way around and still have the same level of weld deposit. Gravity is a thing. Well, let's watch that again at half speed, at slow-mo. Okay, well, there's the root pass, or at least a good deal of it. And I lost some files in recording this video, and for some reason didn't even record a complete shot of the cover pass, but I did have this that I posted on Instagram on a story. So I say had it saved on my phone, so you can kind of get an idea of what the cap looked like. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.